So hey, what's up mga kote? It's me, Ate Mariel, at welcome sa Kodernos, where learning is the name of the game. So kung bago ka pa lamang sa aming YouTube channel, i-click mo na subscribe, like, and share button para may update ka sa aming mga videos. So samahan natin si Super K sa panibagong araw at panibagong lesson na ating matututunan dito sa Kodernos. At ang bagong lesson natin for today is all about the weather chart. So dito naman, di ba, last time na pag-aralan natin yung humidity. So, ito naman yung weather chart natin. So, para magiging Mang Tani tayo tsaka Kuya Kim. So, dito malalaman natin, of course, pwede nating ma-record kung ano yung weather for that day. So, pwede din tayong maging isang observer about sa naging weather for a specific day. For example, ngayon, check mo kung ano weather ngayon. Sunny ba? Ano ba ang itsura ng sky? Cumulus ba? Cirrus clouds ba? So, ganon. So, before we start our lesson, of course, meron muna tayong trivia for today. So, fact, human noses and ears get bigger as we age. So, at I think it's true. So, nung bata ako, parang iba yung shape ng ilong ko. Ewan ko kung bakit. Basta iba yung shape ng ilong ko. Tapos, parang nag-grow siya ng konti. Pati yung ears ko. So, ayan, nag-grow din siya. It's pretty common to see the claim that our nose and ears are the only parts of our body that kept growing as we age. But that's not exactly true. Our nose and ears stop growing along with the rest of our body. But thanks to the weight of gravity, both parts continue to lengthen over time according to the Discovery Channel. So of course, So of course, ang ating height ay nag-grow, yung legs natin nag-grow, yung arms natin. So, yan, dumadagdag yung height natin. So, pati rin, ang ears and nose, nag-grow siya. So, hindi siya dahil sa, dahil siya sa weight of gravity. So, yung parte, yung dalawang yon ay nag-grow pa rin over time. So, yan yung ating trivia for today. So, human nose says and ears get bigger as we age. So, dito na tayo sa ating lesson proper. Dito na tayo sa weather chart. You have learned the different conditions that determine the weather. Now, you can experience observing weather changes. You can use the weather instruments that the Weather Bureau uses or you can use those you have made yourself. So, inong grade 5 kami, pinagawa kami ng wind vane and anemometer. So, syempre, katulong si Papa, we made up, that's our project. So, gawa kaming wind vane. Kasi yung topic namin is about weather. Kung paano madedetermine yung weather. So, yung mga wind speed, ganyan. So, pinagawa kami as our project. So, yan. You can set up a weather station in your school. Place weather instruments in the proper places. The thermometer should be in a shady place. So, the rain gauge, the wind vane, and the anemometer should be in an open space. When it is a cloudy, observe the sky above and as far around so as you can see. So yan, syempre sa school, pwede ka maging weather forecast. Mag-weather forecast. So meron ka dapat tools, thermometer, para syempre malaman mo yung temperature ng araw na. For example, 35 degrees, 40 degrees, gaano ba kainit, gaano ba kalamig, ano yung itsura ng clouds, cumulus ba, cirrus ba, so ayan, cirrostratus ba, so ayan. So make a weather chart which you can fill up from day to day, use the symbols that you have learned. So you can record it every day. So for example, di ba sa cellphone natin, meron tayong app. So it's installed app na before we buy the cellphone, meron na talagang apps siya about weather. So, bubuksan mo lang yung location mo and you will see the weather. So, I'll try this on my cellphone. So, before we try it on my cellphone, so, meron ako ditong weather weather app. So, ayan. Try to make your observations at about the same time each day. So, record your observations right away. Use a table similar to this. So, ayan yung table, weather report. So, temperature, wind speed, wind direction, air pressure, sky covering, rainfall, humidity, and weather. So, dito, nandito na ako sa app ko na weather. So, ayan. So ang ating ano dito is 27 degrees Celsius at ang kanyang weather type is mostly cloudy. So yan. So today sunny siya, ayan. Tomorrow sunny. So nagpe-predict na siya ng weather sa mga sumusunod na araw. So yan. Meron na dito ang ano, humidity 65%, pressure 1013. HPA, so real feel, 30 degrees Celsius. So, ENE force is 2. So, meron tayong app na ganyan. Meron tayong mga ganyan sa mga cellphones. So, sa akin, it's Vivo. So, meron kang weather. So, alam ko meron ng lahat. So, that's the type na pwede mo rin ma-determine aside from this weather report. Meron kang weather app. Of course, all ngayon, puro modernity na lang tayo and puro tayo gadgets. So, that's why nakaka-determine agad tayo ng mabilis. So, for example, Monday, 30 degrees, naging 21. So, wind speed natin, moderate. Tapos dito, fast. Northeast, yung wind direction is northeast. Parehong northeast. Ang air pressure is a rising, is a falling. Yung sky covering niya, ganyan. Para siyang moon. So, yung rainfall none. So, yan. Yung Tuesday, 3 centimeter. Humidity, 65%. Wala sa Tuesday. And yung weather, fair. Tapos dito, wala. By looking at the different weather conditions, you can tell what kind of weather it will be. Fair, cloudy, rainy, or stormy. So, yan. Malalaman mo talaga agad. Depende sa temperature, depende sa wind speed, depende sa air pressure, at depende rin sa temperature. So, next tayo. Visit a weather station if there's one in your place. So, notice then observe the instruments like the ones in the picture. Instrument which has an arrow is a wind vane. The arrowhead points to the direction from the where the wind is blowing. The wind vane points to the northeast. So, dito naman sa kabila, the instrument with cups that rotate is an anemometer. It tells how fast the wind is blowing. When the air is still, the anemometer is also still. When the wind is moving fast, the cups rotate fast also. So, para siyang ano, kung hindi mo ihipan, hindi siya gagalaw. So, ganun yung ating explanation about sa kung paano gagamitin yung anemometer. You can observe the direction and speed of the wind by just observing the movement of leaves and trees. The speed of wind may be described as slow, moderate, or strong. So, pag slow, syempre, mahina. Pag moderate, medyo tama lang. So, hindi siya sobra, hindi siya kulang. Pag strong, ayan. So, yan, malakas-lakas na yan. So, this is an example. This is the wind vane. So, yan, ito yung wind vane, yung may arrow. Yung anemometer, para siyang cup. So, yan yung mga instruments na ginagamit for weather. So, thank you. Have a great day and God bless. So, click the thumbs up button if you like this video and leave a comment down below if you have suggestions, clarifications, and questions to our future videos. So, thank you. Have a great day and God bless. See you in my next video. Bye-bye!